Yo, that's so old.
Yeah, welcome back to the Sports Smack Zone. Each year, La Liga invites social media influencers from all parts of the world to converge in Spain for the annual La Liga experience. Through the La Liga experience, these influencers are given the opportunity to attend upon a La Liga match, tour the host city and meet with players, among other exciting activities. Representing Sportsmax this year is comedian Dale Elliott. He'll be in Seville from April 9 to 14. Now, La Liga has been successfully implementing these experiences in Spain through the active participation of international celebrities in the project. And yeah, Lisa just showed him to you. Dale is on set to talk about the La Liga experience. Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, you told me off air that you're an Arsenal fan.
Yes, I am a die-hearted Arsenal
fan. Spoiling the interview before the interview started.
That's just how
long have you been a Gunner?
Well, I've been a Gunner since 2006.
Yeah.
Six.
I was 10 years old. That was when I could actually have enough sense.
I should be kind to him because he's a young football fan.
Yeah, yes.
No problem. All right. Tell me about, how did you get involved with this thing now to be going off to Spain to the Seville Derby?
Well, I got Tori contacted me.
Yes.
From Sportsmax. She was like, we're interested in taking you to Spain. I never really hear what she said after that. I mean, you just hear Spain and La Liga, you know? I'm very interested if you see some of the players them. Can't wait for you to Spain. You know, the second best football player in the world, they are Spain. You know, Messi, he's there. He's behind Cristiano Ronaldo. I'm just getting it out there before we reach any further in the show. Yeah.
So aren't you embarrassed about that, though? That the best footballer in the world, according to you, is not a Gunner. It's a Manchester United. We made him.
I wouldn't say you made him. His mother and father made him. But as it relates to him, his best days were at Real Madrid, which is a La Liga club right now.
Yes.
And that's where, that's the team that I like in, because he only can support one team,
yes,
me. That's the team that I like in Spain right now.
And of course, Juve is your Serie A team now then.
Naturally. Okay. Everywhere Christy goes, I'm going.
I understand.
So if he plays for Harborview next season, I am a Harborviewian, if there's a word like that.
There you go. Excellent. But so you say you like Real Madrid in Spain.
Yes.
La Liga. What does La Liga mean for you? Because clearly you watch football. So you know.
Yes.
What does La Liga mean?
I like La Liga. I personally think it's a three-horse race, to be honest. Yes. Yes, it's just the regular Barcelona, Madrid, Atletico.
Yeah, year after year.
Yeah. Mm. Sevilla chip in one and two times, but that's in Europe.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, Valencia had its glory days in the early 2000s, but not really getting from Valencia right now. But Barca gone with the league, clear. Madrid is up right now. Zidane is back. Don't know why he left in the first place, but he's back now.
Yeah.
So I'm better. It's looking on the up.
You read Gareth Bale?
Gareth Bale, yes, but I think he's the most inconsistent player in La Liga. But he has so much potential. He's so good.
Dale, can I make one thing clear though? Because even though we accept that the bottom teams, you just said that's a three-horse race in La Liga, but even though the bottom teams may not be pretty strong, if you look at the entire European landscape of football, but the style, sometimes when I see matches between Leganés and Eibar, the style is very watchable. The quality and the individual skills.
That is what I love about La Liga.
Yeah, they may not be outstanding teams.
They're probably not as competitive as as English league, but the style of football.
Yeah, man, looks nice.
It's like, the man know about defending, man. Right now, Sergio Ramos is the second leading goal scorer, and he's the centre back.
A two-part question for you, A and B. Who is a social media influencer?
Yes.
And why are you so good being one?
Well, a social media influencer, I used to just give jokes on Instagram. I still do that. That's what I do. I use my phone, I go on Instagram, I make funny videos, anything that I find relatable. So for instance, if the other day when Manchester United, I don't know if them buy the referee or what, but the other day when Manchester United get away with
PSG.
With murder.
Yeah.
Yes, I was on the internet, I was vlogging about it. I I managed to amass a following.
Yes.
Yeah.
From young people and older people.
Yeah.
And it was like, sometimes they like my commentary. Yeah. If you're honest, I like World Cup time. I'm commenting about the World Cup.
You realize these Manu utterances, though, could abort this interview.
I'm seeing that. Are you a Manchester United fan?
Yes, yes, yes.
Wow, I see you guys like history. You guys pass history. Right? I know you guys pass history class. Now that's a history club right now. That's just where Manu is right now. You guys spend the money, though. Eventually, it will come if you spend the money, right?
So you make the videos and you...
I made them, yeah. I edit them, and I post them on my Instagram.
How many followers do you have on Instagram?
126,000.
Oh, what is... What
and
is
it's global.
What, yes.
What is a sign that... What number do you have to pass, Ellie, to make it obvious that... No, but you have 126,000, I'm saying. So, am I popular on Instagram if I have 20,000, 50,000, 100? What's the number?
To be honest, being popular, followers is relative. It's just If you can see yourself on other people's pages,
yes.
That's when you know you are actually doing a good job. Mm. So, for instance, you only make Instagram videos, but you are on somebody's WhatsApp story and you click and you see your face and you're like, wow. And it's when you start seeing yourself on other platforms and you're only using one, that's when you can say, yeah, you are actually popular. But to be honest, the followers, that it looks good, but if your followers aren't interactive, you really... You know?
Well, you're also in an acting, are you?
Yes.
A movie? Sprinting?
Yes, I did a
Sprinter.
Movie. It's called Sprinter. It's been released in Jamaica in May and in the US and in April. April 24th.
That's you there. So yeah, can you really run though, for real?
Yes, I went to Kingston College.
Yeah, but
I
that doesn't answer the question. It doesn't answer the question.
I did track and field in Kingston College.
Oh, you did?
Yes. I was unfortunately a part of the generation that didn't win a champs.
Yes.
But
yes.
I saw it last week.
Yes. So yes. You actually ran at champs?
Yes.
Okay. He's a good athlete, to be fair.
Yeah.
If you can make a Kingston College team at champs, it means that you have quality.
If you make the Gipsy team alone, you can run a case. If you get jersey.
Yeah. La Liga. You're going to watch the Seville derby while you're there. You're going to Sevilla versus Real Betis at the Sanchez Pizjuan in Seville. What are you expecting in terms of the atmosphere and the whole experience?
Well, the commentary in Spain is very funny because these guys say, them start say goal from like 3 o'clock and like on a whole half time, them are say goal from me really interested to see if that is like the whole goal. And the people, I see like people are always in the stands and them are, you know, I've never really experienced a football game in Europe, so I'm super excited, to be honest. And there are a few players for Sevilla that I like, you know, Evo Benega.
Yeah.
Because Sevilla is my team in FIFA where, you know, when I want to show up somebody and they feel like I'm not using a good team, so I just choose Sevilla. But they know that I have like Jesus Navas and Benega.
Them, good people.
Yeah, we can have string passes. Although excellent. Everybody in Spain basically can do that.
Look for it. Excellent. So while there, he'll attend a Sevilla training session, he'll attend the pre-match press conference, he'll tour the Sanchez Pizjuan, he'll meet players and he'll be in the VIP area, and they say he'll be doing a gastronomic tour of Seville. I hope you don't get gastro.
Gastronomic tour?
Yeah, it's just food.
Basically, I'm a frog.
Careful of the frog. Look, all the best to you.
Yeah, man.
And congratulations. Yeah, I'll represent well. Well, I don't have to tell you to represent well. I know you will.
Yes, yes.
Excellent. All right.
Thank you very much.
Excellent. Fine. The man is on Instagram. He has 100,000 followers on Instagram. And yeah, he pops up on people's timelines and social media all over. And yeah, he's happening right now. La Liga experience.
I know my grandfather. I watch it. So yo, daddy. Make it, you know, bongo. Remember, say it if you watch TV, you know, it's a call when we come off. Is it?